did MBBS and then MD preventive medicine from KM Hospital, Bombay. And this study was carried out in Madhoba Cardiac Rehabilitation Center, which is located 50 kilometers away from the Mumbai city. And it is the world's first Ayurvedic cardiac rehabilitation center. And it is the best example of integrative approach towards the heart disease. So, even though it's a intervention is through the Ayurveda, all these parameters that we have chosen to compare the results are from the allopathic background. So the title of this study, as displayed here, is the SHS, that is Sampurna Hruday Shuddhikaran, an Ayurvedic intervention to improve the exercise tolerance in chronic heart failure. As we all know, the chronic heart failure can be diagnosed in terms of reduced the exercise tolerance capacity. Whenever there is a chronic heart failure, 100% there is reduced the exercise tolerance capacity will be there because of reduced the pumping capacity of the heart. And that is because of the reduced the cardiac output. And the main cause of this is maybe because of the weakening or stiffening of the heart muscles. So Ayurveda is the total cure for such kind of disease like chronic heart failure by increasing exercise tolerance capacity. If you go through the research, we'll find after angioplasty or bypass, what we get is the improvement in the 30 to 40 meters after 6 to 7 months. But here this intervention we carry out for just 7 days and we get the improvement in the exercise tolerance capacity of 70 meters approximately. So we'll see in the detail that congestive heart failure is a major cardiac disease worldwide. If you go through the statistics, we'll find mortality of this disease or the mortality because of this heart disease is going on increasing from 2005 to 2010. We'll find from 1.5 million people to 2.5 million people are dying because of this heart disease. Plus more than 60 million people are suffering from the chronic heart disease. So Ayurveda can be the total cure for this. So we'll see in detail how this can be proved. And also lack of resources and costly treatment like angioplasty and bypass for the heart disease becomes the major burden, socioeconomic burden for the patients of the developing nations. So as I mentioned, it's chronic heart failure is because of maybe the stiffening or what we can call weakening of the heart muscle. So this is the prevalence and mortality status of the India or in developing nations. So we'll come directly to the materials and methods. So we have selected non-randomly 86 patients through our Madhoba Cardiac Rehabilitation Center. And these 86 patients were selected after their informed consent. And the sample size was 86. Out of them, we'll see in detail the male and female difference. So they were given the SHR, that is Sampurna Hruday Shuddhikaran procedure, which is of 90 minutes. And upon admission of these all subjects, they were tested for their exercise tolerance through the 6-minute walk test, which is recognized by the American Heart Association as a standard method to judge the exercise tolerance. Also, Madhoba has got their own protocol for stress testing, that is MCRC protocol. And this is the inclusion and exclusion criteria. The patients between the age of 17 to 80 were selected after informed consent. And the patient who gets admitted in the Madhoba are only of the NYHA classification of 1, 2 and 3 symptoms. and the patient, those who are excluded out of the study were having NYHA grade 4 symptoms and history of MI in the last 2 weeks and having the severe joint disability. Also, the patients who have the hepatic and renal failure were also excluded. Pregnancy and lactation, and also acute conditions like fractures also excluded from the study. And uncontrolled hypertension, and those who are having the ejection fracture of less than 30% were also ejected from the study. What is this Sampurna Hriday Shuddhikaran? It includes the 4 steps, that is Sneher, Svedan, Rudhdhara and Basti. So this is the slide which explains you about the SHS. What happens in the Sneher? We give the tail oil centripetal massage in strokes directed towards the heart. In Svedan, what we do, we give the herbal moist steam bath with the help of Terminalia Arjuna bath. Rudhdhara, we give the herbal decoction in precordial area. In Basti, what we give is the herbal enema of Ayurvedic drug like Ajur. And what are the results? We find these are the 6-minute walk test and stress test. That I will not go in detail about the criteria, but the speed which we keep for stress test is the 1.6 km per hour. We go on increasing till 5 minutes and we then keep constant till 9 minutes. And we have given inclination of the 2 degree till 4th minute and then gradually increase by 2 degree till 9 minute. The male and female were 70% male and 30% female. What the results were, 6 minute walk test improvement were from 454 to 531 and stress test from 376 seconds to 500 and not 503 seconds. These parameters were found highly significant on statistical analysis. So what is the rationale behind this? The Sneher and oil massage, what we do in SHS, gives rise to reduction of the vascular tone. And the Svedan, Rudhdhara and the systemic local thermal vasodilatation gives you the reduction in the salt and water retention. What we call it allopathic is the it helps in reducing the preload of the heart. And lastly, this rectal infusion of the cardiac herb that gives you increase in the cardiac contractibility. This way we can say that we can treat the patient of systolic and diastolic heart failure with the help of this SHS. So what are the results? That these are significant. But discussion, the improvement was significant, no adverse effect were observed. And what is the conclusion? That Sampurna Hriday Shuddhikaran improves the exercise tolerance capacity in chronic heart failure patients, and this improvement is independent of age, sex and BMI. So with this, I would like to end this topic, and thank you for giving me opportunity to present my topic over here. Thank you very much.